Hey guys, welcome to the third video in this series where I'm gonna show you how to add additional details with hide information inside Substance 3D Painter. Let's go ahead and jump straight into it. All right, so now that we know how to work with masks and how to create our custom ID maps and all of that, I wanna show you another tip that I think it is fantastic. And that comes down to the amount of details that you wanna have in your models. So again, I'm gonna go back into ZBrush and let's go ahead and toggle all of these off so that we can concentrate on the model rather than the color. Because this is a model that has 10 million polygons, right? And it's pretty smooth and I wanna keep it to this level. But if I wanted to do like some kind of panel, right? So I'm gonna select a damn standard brush, which is kind of like a knife brush in here, right? To do this type of indentations. So that's fine, right? If I wanna do a panel like this, let's do a panel from here to here to here to here, something like this, right? Like as a sculpted line. Obviously, this is horrible in terms of the execution, but I just wanna show you that because I'm limited to the resolution, this line is not gonna be very, very sharp. And I want this to be very clean and sharp, right? If I do another one, let's do something along the lines of this, maybe a connective line like so, right? Again, because of the topology of this asset and the amount of resolution, this is gonna be very low. So I have alternatives. Obviously, I can go ahead and increase the resolution of this quite a bit. I can use, in ZBrush, there is a tool called HD Geometry that allows you to create virtual geometry as well. So there is ways of sculpting this very, very nicely and neatly. But because I know I'm going to take this into Painter, let's undo all of this one. I know that I can do that. I can generate all of these tiny details that probably are not going to be as visible unless you do a close-up from Painter, and the quality is going to be much, much better because it's going to be relying on the resolution of the map. Okay, so that is kind of like a little intro of why I would decide to do this in Painter rather than in ZBrush. And if I go into Painter, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new fill layer in here, and I'm going to call this one Hide. All right, and I'm going to right click and I'm going to give it a red color. I tend to use a red kind of like tagging system to, you know, so I know that anything that is red in my layer stack, it has the hide information enabled. So that is easy to come back and you know, tweak it a little bit. So I'm going to enable metal, rough, and normal. So all of them together. And this, again, is going to be for the panels. So I'm going to use, let's try it, a green color. I tend to do this all the time. I have a course online called The Extra Mile, and this is exactly how I teach it in that course because it allows you to visualize whatever you're doing a lot better, and we use a non-destructive workflow, so I can come back and edit this at any point. I'm gonna use this color. All right, so now I'm gonna click on black mask, so that hides that green. So it is still there, but we are creating a mask that covers everything, and it hides it. Now in the magic one, I'm gonna click on add paint layer. All right, so that is about all we need to do in terms of the setup, right? Now the next part would be to draw those lines. So if you have like a steady hand, not like me, If you have steady hand, you can just go ahead and start painting this like so, and that'll be quite easy if you can do it. However, there's a much better way of doing this type of thing. So for that, I'm gonna go ahead and click on this icon, which is the path tool. So the path tool allows you to use a Bezier curve or like use points. So I can literally, let's actually start here from the back. So I'm gonna click, yeah, and also I'm using symmetry, and I'm gonna click on those points. So, and don't worry about the size of this. I know this is not a panel, but I'm just gonna go through this and show you some, you know, an initial setup. All right, I think that works. I'm gonna go ahead and press enter. Obviously, this is not a panel. That doesn't look like a panel, but this is one of the things that I wanna show you. So you can change this to absolutely anything that you want. So you can select that pan or that path, right? Let's actually bring back everything. And with that path selected, you can change the type of brush and you can change a bunch of things. So if I click on the size, I can reduce that size and you see how it just changed that panel. So this is actually the brush that I might want to use for the panel. Or if I don't want to have this kind of like soft edge, increase that sort of like gradient towards the edges, we can switch to a different brush. So I'm going to click on the brush here and let's go ahead and type hard brush. So if I click now, again, you have to have the path selected, otherwise it's not gonna make any difference. I'm gonna click on basic hard, and you see now the edges are a little bit sharper. So I can reduce that size, and we're gonna have a very nice and clean panel there, or you know, like a cut of a panel. You can also change the spacing, so you can increase that spacing, and that is ultimately going to added space between the instances of that sort of tip of the brush. In my case, I want something that is continuous. I'm going to reduce the spacing. And maybe this is still a little bit too big. So let's reduce the size like so. All right. So I'm going to press Enter again. So we have a panel. Now, another thing that you notice is in here, I'm kind of like losing the path. That is because if I select on that, this one right here, from this, hopefully you can see, there's kind of like a missing point. So I need to add a point in between here. So let's click on that one. And now it has a much better chance to show that line. Right? It's still not perfect, but let's increase the depth of that projection. All right, there we go. Okay, now another cool thing that you can do is, let's say if you want to have a sharper corner here, you can double click this point and that makes it a sharp corner. So I can do maybe another one here. So double click that point and now this becomes a sharp corner. You can ignore this one right here. Again, I'm going to avoid that at the end. And it's non-destructive, so you can move this around, right? So this is another cool thing. So again, press Enter. And just for the sake of demo, I'm going to create another panel in here. But this time I'm going to use a different tool. So I'm going to choose this option here, or this path type. You can also click and hold from the left menu and click on Fill Path. So this is one of the new things that have been added into Painter recently. So it allows you to create a path and close that path like so, and it will create a fill layer in there, or it's going to fill that section quite easily. So again, I'm going to double click these points to make sure everything is nice and sharp, right? And then it's non-destructive, so I can move these points at any point. And let's press Enter. Right, so I have these two sections or these two areas, but I'm going to concentrate mostly on this path because that's ultimately the type of detail that I want to add. So again, the whole point of making this layer green is so that I can clearly see where the path is going to be and I can, you know, modify the curvature and all of that. But once I know what it is, right, I'm going to go ahead and toggle everything except the height information. I'm pressing the Alt key and clicking on Hide. That way, it removes everything and only leaves the height information. So right now, there is no height information because we set this, or by default, it's set to zero. But now I can take this and push this inwards. And you see, you can push this as much as you want or just a tiny bit, and it creates that information in the texture. So I'm rotating the light, holding the Shift key and right click, and you see the effect. In fact, it is also in here. Now, if you want to smooth this out a little bit so that it's not as sharp, what I would recommend is in the mask itself, on top of the paint layer, you can add a blur. So let's add a blur and let's reduce that a little bit. Check the panel again, want to focus on this. So this one is pretty cool. I think 0.07 is pretty handy and it looks nice, right? So that is about it. But now that I have the setup, again, very, very simple, just using a single layer with height information, a mask and a paint layer using the path tool, I can go ahead and create another paint layer if I want to keep things separate, right? So everything is in a paint layer here. I can click on add paint layer. So I have this one right here that I can add. Let's try another panel. So, you know, something like I showed you before, it could be something like this, like that. And then let's double click on some points just to make them sharper. And this is a lot of fun. Like I can spend some time, because this part, it's, even though it is within the texturing process, I can spend a lot of time just further designing or further taking the design into something that works in the sci-fi world. So I'm gonna press Enter now. Again, so this is a new path. And because it is below the blur, this is still having that sort of blur effect. Let me turn that off so you can see, right? And because it is part of the mask itself, right? All I'm doing is adding lines in white color using the path tool. It's going to have the same information. So now I have this nice panel in here. So you can add a lot of detail, you know, in the texturing process just using this technique. And, you know, if you're doing something like this, like a sci-fi asset, you know, this type of panels, it sort of brings that asset into that world quite easily. I think it looks cool. So this is how you do those panels just using the height information. All right, so hopefully you find this useful as well. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.